Social, we are waiting to see you, what you're taking us through today. And yes, we have been following your exercises that you showed us. Enjoy doing it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so yeah, can you hear me?
Very yes. Well.
Okay, okay. So it's very good that you're exercising and you are practicing what I told you last time. So I'm very happy and very impressed. और ये टाइम मुझे मिस्टर साले ने बोला है कि हिंदी और इंग्लिश में मैं कंबाइन करूँगी, सो आई विल स्पीक इन इंग्लिश. ओके. एंड लास्ट टाइम भी हमारा जो सेशंस हुआ था, सो दैट वर वेरी इंटरैक्टिव, सो आई ट्राई एंड मेक इट एज इंटरैक्टिव एज पॉसिबल. सो आई ट्राई एंड डू माई प्रेजेंटेशन और उसके बाद फिर देन मे बी वी कैन हैव अ डिस्कशन अराउंड व्हाट आई टॉक. ओके, सो माई प्रेजेंटेशन. Yeah, so can you see it?
Not yet.
You have to press the share button. The bottom
share screen.
Share button.
In green color, share screen is written. On the bottom, share screen is written. Okay. Green color.
Yeah, okay.
Can you find it or should I do it?
No, it's visible.
Yes, yeah, we can see it.
Okay.
Amrita, just put it on the presentation board. Yes.
Perfect.
Okay.
Sally, there's some noise in the background. Can you just mute everybody? I don't know from where that sound is coming. As if there's some water running or I don't know, something. Thank you. Yes, Amrita, you can start.
Okay. So, aaj ka hamara jo vishay hai, that is change as an older adult. Okay. So, generally, we think that as an older adult, as an older person, someone maybe who is above 60 years of age, change is not possible. Okay, so we ourselves tell ourselves that, or maybe the society calls us stubborn, or maybe resistant, or maybe there is rigidity, there is inflexibility, not open to new ideas. So basically all these characteristics are attached to older adults. Okay, so basically what I have done is, are these, whatever is said, is it true? So I have tried to look at studies, I have tried to look at brain studies, I have tried to look at gerontological studies, which is what I do. So gerontology is the holistic study of aging from biological, social, psychological aspects. So basically, can older adults change? Okay, and if change is possible, then what can you do? What steps can you take? So I'm going to talk basically about this. Okay, so ye 1890 mein William James, who is called the father of modern psychology, American psychology. So in 1890, he wrote a book called Principles of Psychology, in which he said that in most of us by the age 30, character has set like plaster and will never soften again. Okay, so basically he's saying that character will not change, personality will not change, traits in a person will not change, a person will not be able to change past the age of 30. So this is what he had said. Okay, so now is it really true? So further studies were done, and what do further studies say? इसके बाद एक बिग फाइव सर्वे हुआ. ओके, एंड इन दिस बिग फाइव सर्वे पर्सनैलिटी वॉज थॉट टू बी अ पैटर्न ऑफ थॉट्स, बिहेवियर्स एंड फीलिंग्स, एंड दे सेड दैट इट इज मोस्टली कंसिस्टेंट ऑफ दीज फाइव ट्रेट्स, दीज बेसिक फाइव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट आर दीज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स? Okay, so the first one is extroversion. Extroversion as in how cheerful you are, or maybe, you know, how outgoing you are, or maybe how full of energy, enthusiasm in social settings. Okay, so that is extroversion. Second is agreeableness. Okay, so how warm you are, how friendly, how helpful, how generous, how tactful you are. Okay, so this was the second trait that they saw. The third trait that they saw was emotional stability. Okay, so how content you are. Okay, so are you easily disturbed by things around you? Versus are you very anxious or are you very angry or are you very jealous or am I very lonely or am I very insecure? So these things were, taken under emotional stability. The next one is conscientiousness. Okay, so how organized am I? How efficient am I? And how committed am I? Okay, so what are my values? Okay, so do I hold any values? Okay, so conscientiousness, what's that? The fifth one was openness to experience. Okay, so whether I am really open to new things, whether I am really open to accepting new things. So basically what they did was they studied a group of American adolescents in the 1960s. Okay, they studied a group of American adolescents in the 1960s and they studied these same adolescents on these five characteristics after 50 years. After 50 years, they again studied the same people. Okay, and what happened? What were the findings? Okay, so they found that while early personalities provided a baseline, they are as malleable as we age. Malleable as in they are changeable. Okay, so even though my early personality might be of a particular type, my personality can change. And this is what they found in that study. Secondly, they also found that personality is cumulative over our lifespan. Personality is cumulative, yani changes take place in parts. Okay, so to give you my own example, I was when my daughter was born, I was a bit patient. But you know, now when she's around 6 years of age, I have become more patient. Okay, so basically change does not happen all of a sudden. It happens in parts. Okay, so this is what is meant by personality is cumulative. And then this study said that change happens gradually, as is also, clear from the fact that personality is cumulative, that change happens gradually in parts, even as an adult and even into old age. Okay, so whatever William James was saying, that character is set in stone, that it does not change, past the age of 30, was totally nullified by this study. And even further studies have challenged his notion. Okay, and I think, the fact that older adults cannot change, I have heard that quite a lot. And maybe even in society, there is this, prevailing kind of notion, this belief that, we will not be able to change. You can't change older adults. Okay. So we saw the first study and then it was actually, this first study was called 16 going on 66. Okay. So American adolescents studied after 50 years, the same people studied, around the same characteristics. Okay. Then there was this book called, which was written by Brian Little. Okay. And the name of the book was Me, Myself and Us, The Science of Personality and the Art of Well-being. Okay. So he wrote this book, Brian Little, also a psychologist. Okay. And what did he say? What did Brian Little say in his book? He said that we are not victims of our genes or circumstances. Okay, and he said that we can choose how to behave to a certain extent. And Brian Little went to the extent of saying that not only can I choose how to behave, not only can my personality change, not only can my personality change in adulthood or in old age, but he also said that I can go against my nature and act differently to what my nature is. He gives his own example where he has said that he basically was a very reserved person. But when he spoke in front of a group, his personality totally changed. Whatever he wanted to convey, he was very, very, enthusiastic. And, the way he kind of tried to convey his message was very different from his reserved nature. So basically, when we really want to do a particular thing, when we are determined to do a particular thing, when we are motivated to do a particular thing, we can also go against our own nature. Okay, so we can choose how to behave to a certain extent. Okay, so he said that personality is influenced by the by genes also, and also by your environment. So basically, he's saying that we can choose how to behave. And secondly, he's saying that we can also go against our own nature. Okay, so whenever the situation demands, okay, and if the person is really willing, you can go against your own nature also. So ye Brian Little ne kaha. Dusra study aur ek aaya, which was done by the University of Edinburgh, Scotland. Aur yahan pe bhi inhone ye kiya ke, you know, how character traits shift. So ye unhone study kiya. Aur isme unhone basically, they studied six, you know, personality traits. Okay, और इसमें I'll tell you the six personality traits, but they studied 1,200 people, 1,200 people, 14-year-old students, 14 years of age, and then they studied these 14-year-old students when they were 77 years of age. Okay, so when 77 years of age, and what were these six traits? These six traits were self-confidence, again conscientiousness, perseverance, desire to excel, originality, and stability of moves. Okay, so I'll again just repeat. They studied self-confidence, conscientiousness, perseverance, desire to excel, originality, and stability of moves. So ye six personality characteristics ko unhone study kiya, and what did they find? Okay, at the age of 77. Okay, so they again gave a personality assessment, and what were their findings? They found that the younger and the older self seem to bear no resemblance to each person. So the way your younger self was, the older self was totally different. So the personality had changed. Okay, so either the person had become more conscientious, there was more conscientiousness in the person had become more agreeable. But the way the person was in his younger years, the older self was totally different. Okay. And then this study also says that personality changes only gradually, but by older age, it may be very different from the personality in childhood. So basically what we are trying to say is that personality is changeable even after the age of 30, even into adulthood and even into old age. ओके एंड जो विलियम जेम्स ने बोला था 1890 में वो ये स्टडीज ने पूरे तरीके से उसको चैलेंज करके उसको पूरे तरीके से नलिफाई कर दिया. ओके नाउ दिस इज यू नो सो बेसिकली वी आर सेइंग दी स्टडीज आर सेइंग दैट बिहेवियर इज मैलिएबल. ओके सो बिहेवियर इज चेंजेबल इवन इनटू ओल्ड एज. ओके एंड उसके बाद जो ब्रेन पे स्टडीज हुए हैं सो दैट आई एम गोइंग टू पुट फॉरवर्ड इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. So in gerontology, and I think we had spoken about it briefly last time, there is something called neuroplasticity. Okay, so plasticity means changeableness, okay, and neuro. So the nerves can also change. Okay, so neuroplasticity is basically the brain's ability to adapt. Okay, so whatever changing circumstances are there in a person's life, the brain constantly adapts to the changing circumstances, to the changing situations. It does not remain the same. Okay, and the connections in our cells change according to the changing needs. Okay, so these connections in the cells change according to the changing needs. So that is what neuroplasticity says. And it also says that right from the time the person is in the uterus till the time we die, the connection in these cells, they keep on reorganizing. Okay, so these connections keep on changing in our cells. So that is what is neuroplasticity in simple words. Okay, so now even in neuroplasticity, in the 1900s, the father of neuroplasticity What did he say? That a person's brain can change even after adulthood. Okay, so neuroplasticity, even brain studies are saying the same thing. So even in the 1900s, it was thought that nerve paths, the nerve cells, the paths in the nerve cells are fixed. Okay, they are not changeable. Okay, they are immutable. So that is what they had thought. But now with these recent changes, this neuroplasticity was found. I mean, it was they studied about that and they thought that brain has the ability to adapt even in adulthood and even in old age. Okay, so neuroplasticity is also related to the growth mindset. Okay, so these cells will reorganize. These cells will connect between themselves. But when will they connect? When a person has a growth mindset. So what is this growth mindset? That one can get better or more skilled at something with sustained effort, and abilities can be developed or improved with determination. Okay, so sustained effort is required. One can become more skilled at something. Okay, so basically these nerve cells will reorganize. These nerve cells will connect, but it requires a stimuli. It requires some kind of a stimulation for it to reorganize. Okay, so with sustained effort and determination, you can learn new skills and a person can change. So growth mindset is extremely important. Okay, so basically, how can this neuroplasticity be applied? Okay, so we talked about what is neuroplasticity, but how can we apply it in our daily lives? Okay, so how can it be applied? The first thing is enriched environments. Okay, so in our environments, there has to be novelty, there has to be focus. We have to pay attention to whatever we want to remember. And also there has to be a challenge. If you go on doing the same thing again and again, then this neuroplasticity will not apply to your brain. Okay, so they also did a small experiment with rats. And, there was this control group and they did an experiment, with one group. So with one group, they gave a very enriched environment where, these rats had a lot of seesaws and, swings and whatever. So basically mazes. So these rats had to go through those mazes. So they had basically a very challenging kind of an environment, enriched environment. And in the other group, there was absolutely nothing. Okay, so they were just sitting, not doing anything. So basically it was found that with these enriched environments can also provoke growth and positive adaptation long after critical learning takes place. Okay, so enriched environments are extremely important if our brains have to grow and if change has to take place. Secondly, cognitive training. Okay, so by cognitive training, we basically mean some kind of a brain training in which we practice cognitive skills and we also practice memory, attention, language skills. So these kind of trainings are also extremely important. Okay, so cognitive training is also extremely important, and the kind of training or whatever, the kind of sessions that you have constantly in Tare Social are also a good example of cognitive training where your brain is exercised. The third is physical activity. Okay, so physical activity is also, extremely important, and through physical activity also neuroplasticity can be applied. So it says that physical activity can prevent or slow the normal age-related neuronal death. Okay, so basically if any kind of stimulus is not provided to the brain, then the cells in the brain tend to die off. And it is said that almost 85,000 cells die per day. Okay, so if you do not want all these cells to die, then some kind of a stimulus has to be provided to the brain. And you know, these will die if there is no activity at all, which is given. The fourth important, you know, aspect is traveling. Okay, so so basically they are saying that traveling exposes brain to novel stimuli, and it exposes it to new environments. It opens up new pathways and activity in the brain. Okay, so traveling, being open to new experiences, to new stimuli, is extremely important. Then comes learning a musical instrument. Okay, so this also helps in connectivity between the brain regions, and also helps in forming new neural networks. Okay, so doing something which is challenging is extremely important. Maybe whatever I have been doing, if I continue to do that, then the brain is not going to get stimulated and neuroplasticity cannot be applied. I have to do something that is out of the box. I have to do something by getting out of my comfort zone. Okay, so this is non-dominant hand exercises. Okay, so basically I think we had spoken about this, and Brain Gym also talks a lot about non-dominant hand exercises. So basically they're saying if I generally write with my right hand, I must try and write with my left hand. If I have a bath with a mug in my right hand, I should try and do it with my left hand. Okay, so basically using the non-dominant hand can also help in forming new neural pathways. Okay, so non-dominant hand exercises are also important. Another interesting thing is reading fiction. Okay, so reading, books, either story books or maybe fiction is extremely important, and that also helps in enhancing the connectivity in the brain. Okay, the other, expanding vocabulary. Okay, so when you expand your vocabulary, when you try and, learn new words, so basically research says that it activates the visual and auditory processes, as well as it helps in improving the memory processing. Okay, so expanding your memory also, vocabulary also helps in neuroplasticity. Okay, artwork. Okay, so I think you have a lot of classes related to art. So artwork also is extremely important, and that also helps in connectivity of the brain, and which can also help in boosting introspection, memory, empathy, attention, and focus. Okay, and the last one it says is dancing. Okay, so dancing basically reduces the risk of Alzheimer's and also increases neural connectivity. So all this can be applied. All these things can be basically done for applying neuroplasticity, or basically for improving the brain function. Okay, so effecting change. Okay, so how do we effect change? And there are a lot of studies which have also been done regarding this. So it says that long-lasting change is most likely when it is self-motivated and when it is rooted in positive thinking. Okay, so when it is actually motivated by the self. Okay, so if a lot of people are going to tell me, and if I'm going to take action, that is not going to help. So it has to be self-motivated. Some time back, in my very first session, I had given this example of this lady, 87 years of age, Bokul Chatterjee, who had given her first year BA exam in Kolkata. And, the people, the students in her class were 70 years younger to her. And she faced a lot of ridicule. She was ridiculed. She was basically, people tried to pull her down saying, aap kya kar rahe hai, aise ye sab karne ki zarurat hai kya? This lady had arthritis. She could not see properly. She could not hear properly. But what was her motivation? She said that I do not want to die without taking my BA certificate. I want to get my BA certificate, and then, even if I die, it is okay. So basically this kind of self-motivation is extremely important. Generally what happens is there are a lot of ageist attitudes in society around us. And I think we have spoken about this, where generally people try and tell us that, you know, these things should not be done in old age. You should not be learning. You should not be dancing. You should not be singing. You should not, you should not be looking very good. You should not be kind of mingling with the younger generation. And the older adults also, to some extent, internalize these attitudes or these beliefs that are there in society. Okay, so if long-lasting change has to be there in older adults, it has to be self-motivated and it has to be rooted in positive thinking. Okay, so sometimes what happens is generally people also are motivated by fear, anxiety. So unless and until it is rooted in positive thinking, unless and until I have a positive goal towards me, like Bokul Chatterjee had this goal that, okay, I want to get my BA certificate. Okay, so that kind of positive thinking is required. Okay, so goals are easier to reach if they are specific. If maybe I want to lose weight, goals will have to be specific. Okay, so I'm going to do half an hour of exercise each and every day. So I'm going to cut down on these particular things that I eat. Okay, so goals have to be specific. They need not be very big goals. Okay, so I can have small goals and then try and reach them. So basically limiting the goals that I'm trying to reach, keeping them small. Okay, so only then I will be able to reach my goals, and maybe practical ways of for reaching it. Okay, so, yesterday I was hearing this talk by Milind Soman, you know, where the Prime Minister interviewed him. And I think he's a part of the Fit India movement. So basically Milind Soman said that whatever time he gets, it's either 3 minutes or it's either 30 minutes, whatever time he gets in the day, he generally tends to exercise. He does not go to a gym, or, you know, he does not believe in dieting. All he does is whatever time he gets, he kind of, he is involved in some kind of exercise. Okay, so practical ways for reaching it. So basically, his practical way is that whatever time I get, I am definitely going to indulge in some form of exercise. Okay, so practical ways for reaching it is important, and self-motivation is also extremely important. I'll give you another example of this lady, whom I knew, and she was from a senior citizens association. So she used to go for this light music classes. So around, I think, 77 years of age. And she used to go there. She used to enjoy going for those classes. And, she continued that for around 3-4 months. And then I happened to call her and I asked her, I said, how are your classes going? So she said, I left. So I said, why did you leave? You were enjoying it so much. So she said, आजू-बाजू के लोग सब लोग बोल रहे थे कि ये 77-78 में आपको क्या लता मंगेशकर बनना है क्या? So then, I was like, very demotivated. And then she left those classes. So basically, unless and until it is self-motivated, and even though it might be self-motivated, generally the society will stop us from doing certain things. But unless and until that motivation is high enough, we will not be able to do certain things. Okay, another example which I will give you is of this lady called Harbhajan Kaur. And this lady, Harbhajan Kaur, has started, she basically totally changed from what she was doing earlier. Harbhajan Kaur had not earned a single paisa till the age of 90. Okay, till the age of 90. This lady is based in Chandigarh. Okay, and this lady makes excellent besan ki barfi. And it is so popular, besan ki barfi, that, even Anand Mahindra called her the entrepreneur of the year. Okay, so this lady, at the age of 90, she was talking to her daughter, and she was telling her daughter that the one thing that she regretted in life was that she had not earned her own money at all. And her daughter took that to mind, took that very seriously. And then they started making besan ki barfi at home. That kind of ran quite well. That's why they took a small shop in a market in Chandigarh. And that also ran quite well. And then, she did so well that they took a bigger shop, and it became so popular that even the prime minister, even the chief minister of Punjab said that agar aap Chandigarh aate hain to aapko besan ki barfi khani hi padegi. So this lady till the age of 90 had not earned a paisa in her life. Okay, so change is possible. Okay, if we are determined enough, if we are able to fight, challenge, people in the society, whatever beliefs that they have, if we are able to challenge those beliefs, we will be able to do things. Okay. So tips for change or learning. Okay, so focus is very, very important as older adults. And there are a lot of studies which have been done. Okay, and in those studies, it has been said that whatever distracting stimuli is there, that has to be removed, because generally older adults get affected by noise that is there around, or maybe whatever, if there is some kind of disturbance that is there around. So whatever disturbance is there, generally it is said that younger people will not so much be affected by the noise that is there, but older adults will be very affected. That is why focus, when we are talking about focus, the whatever unnecessary things are there, in the periphery, that needs to be removed. Okay, so basically, and another thing which we also talk about is the self-fulfilling prophecy. Okay, so generally there is this belief that in old age I will not remember. Okay, so if I tell myself that I will not remember, then I will not remember. Okay, so it is like a self-fulfilling prophecy, because I am telling myself, and because I'm also internalizing the fact that I will not remember, my brain is also not going to make any attempts to remember a particular thing. Okay, so focus is extremely important. Paying attention to whatever I want to remember is extremely important. Some time back also, I had given this example of Cicero. Okay, so Cicero, who was a philosopher, Greek philosopher, also wrote a lot about old age. And he said that things which are important for people generally will not forget. Okay, so he was basically saying, he gave the example that an older adult, a person who is aging, will not forget where he has kept his own treasure. He will not forget, because that is extremely important. Okay, so whatever is important, we will not forget. And if we really want to remember, if we really want to learn, if we really want to change, then focus is extremely important. The other important thing is we need to be prepared to stick to the task at hand till some headway is made. We have to be tenacious. We have to stick to things. I will also give you this example of my uncle who unfortunately passed away. And my uncle was doing his law. Okay, so he wanted to do his bachelor's in law. And I think in second year or something, he could not pass one particular exam. He failed at one particular exam. And then, he was so depressed that he completely gave up that course. So even though everyone was telling him, that he had done so well in the other papers, but if he would have given that exam, re-exam, and then, he would have passed it, he himself would have felt so much of satisfaction, but he just gave up. Okay, so that if that tenacity is not there, then people generally tend to give it up. And I think Harivansh Rai Ji Bachchan's poem, kind of conveys this message very well. And I just like to, because it is related, I'll just say that poem, that leharon se dar kar nauka paar nahi hoti, koshish karne walon ki kabhi haar nahi hoti. Nanhi chiti jab dana lekar chalti hai, chadti deewaron par 100 baar fisalti hai. मन का विश्वास रगों में साहस भरता है, चढ़कर गिरना गिरकर चढ़ना ना अखरता है. मेहनत उसकी बेकार हर बार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती. डुबकियां सिंधु में गोताखोर लगाता है, गोताखोर इज अ डाइवर, डुबकियां सिंधु में गोताखोर लगाता है, जा जा कर खाली हाथ लौट कर आता है, मिलते न सहज ही मोती गहरे पानी में, बढ़ता दूना विश्वास इसी हैरानी में, मुट्ठी उसकी खाली हर बार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती। असफलता एक चुनौती है, स्वीकार करो, असफलता एक चुनौती है, इट्स अ चैलेंज, स्वीकार करो, क्या कमी रह गई देखो और सुधार करो, जब तक न सफल हो नींद चैन को त्यागो तुम, संघर्ष का मैदान छोड़ मत भागो तुम, कुछ किए बिना ही जय जयकार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं। सो दैट इज व्हाई टेनेसिटी इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पोर्टेंट, स्टिकिंग टू थिंग्स इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पोर्टेंट, एंड दैट जनरली ओल्डर एडल्ट्स डू नॉट डू, दे डू नॉट स्टिक टू थिंग्स। ओके, अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग विच research has said is that maintained curiosity, curiosity has to be maintained. Okay, why does this happen, why does that happen? And I see my 6 year old is generally so curious about certain things, and compared to her I'm not. Okay, so curiosity has to be maintained. Okay, and that also leads to intellectual growth. Okay, so curiosity has to be maintained. Okay, so focus is extremely important, tenacity, sticking to the task at hand is important, maintaining, preserving that curiosity in life is extremely important, thinking out of the box, doing something which is challenging, doing new things, being open to new ideas is extremely important. Okay, another, this is Dr. Daniel Amen, whom I came across. So there are Amen clinics all over the US, very, very well-known psychiatrist. And they studied, in Amen clinics, they studied around 83,000, they did 83,000 brain scans. And what did they find? And he's also talked a lot about retirement and aging. And what does Dr. Daniel Amen say? Okay, so Dr. Daniel Amen in his article says that when it comes to keeping the brain active, these are the important things which need to be done. The first thing is positive social connections. Okay, so the way our brain is made, we are made to interact. Okay, so isolation is not for us. If a person enjoys isolation, that is another thing altogether. But it is very likely that a person will not enjoy it. So the way the brain is wired, positive connections, interactions with people is extremely important. Okay, and it is said that isolation or loneliness is so fatal that it is as bad as maybe having 15 cigarettes a day. Okay, so that is what studies have shown. So positive social connections are extremely important. New learning, as we have been saying, is extremely important. Then he talks about automatic negative thoughts. He calls them ant, automatic negative thought. And he says that, is it really true what I am thinking? So he says, Dr. Amen says that every stupid thought that comes into my mind, I do not need to believe it. So I need to constantly challenge and I need to ask myself, is it really true? Okay, so if I have things that pull me back, then I have to challenge these thoughts that come into my mind and ask myself, is it really true? Another important thing for maybe keeping ourselves happy and maybe brightening ourselves is gratitude. Okay, so he says, writing 3 things that you are grateful for each day. If you do that for 2 months, your life will definitely change. Okay, so gratitude, being thankful is extremely important. And volunteering, okay, doing something for others is extremely important. Okay, so this can help in building new social networks also. And basically volunteering is so important that it can also reduce mortality rates. Okay, so last time also I had said that generally we do a lot of things for ourselves, but we need to go beyond ourselves and do something for others. So that gives us a different kind of satisfaction and we have a different sense of well-being. Okay, so basically having some kind of a purpose in life, learning, if you do that, change is possible. Whatever you feel that these are the traits which I'm not able to change, it can be changed in old age. If you feel that these are the things that I want to learn, this can be done in old age. But having some kind of a purpose, having some kind of a goal in life is extremely important. So related to that, there is a sher. It says that, Rehne de aasman, zameen ki talash kar. Rehne de aasman, zameen ki talash kar. Sab kuch yahi hai, kahin aur na talash kar. Har aarzu puri ho jaye. Har aarzu, if every desire is fulfilled, har aarzu puri ho jaye, to jeene ka kya maza? Zindagi jeene ke liye, bas ek khoobsurat wajah ki talash kar. So we have to think of that vajay. We have to think of that purpose. Okay? And change is possible. Learning is possible. And old age, is a very good time for doing that. Okay? And Dr. Daniel Amen has said that when you stop learning, your brain starts dying. Okay, so lifelong learning is extremely important. If you do not learn, try to learn anything, your brain, the brain cells that are there will die. The brain connects the nerve cells. There will be no connections between the nerve cells and the brain cells will die. Okay, so learning is extremely important for change. Okay, and generally in old age, we think that keeping up to date or keeping abreast of the things that are going around us is not important. So generally, we do not try and make any efforts for doing that. But staying relevant or understanding what is going on around us is also extremely important, and that requires learning. Okay, so learning is extremely important. Lifelong learning is important, and that will also lead to change in old age. Okay, so changing is possible. If you have a particular goal, change is possible. But lifelong learning is extremely important. Okay, and a goal is extremely important. So thank you very much for listening. I hope I've been able to convey the message. So thank you.
Close your presentation, please, so you can see everybody. Even you will be able to see everyone. Yeah, thank you.
But can I ask a question, please?
Yes.
I wanted to know the name of the book that Brian Little has written.
The name of the book is Me, Myself and Us. It's called Me, Myself and Us. The Science of Personality and the Art of Well-Being. 2014.
Science of?
Personality.
And the Art of Well-Being, 2014.
Thank you. Another thing I wanted to know, reading, you have said fiction reading. You can explain on that, please.
Okay, so basically they have said that, you know, in terms of neuroplasticity can be applied, or the brain function can be improved by reading fiction also. So basically when we try and, read fiction, there might be imaginary characters, and that also leads to, forming connections in the brain.
So fiction could be fairy tale. I mean, things that are not real. Yeah.
Anything that is not real.
Fairy tale. Yeah, fiction is that, yes.
Something that is not real.
Fantastic.
It may not be true. Yeah. So you can, your imagination runs wide. Yes.
What about spiritual reading? Does that help too? Spiritual reading?
If that helps you, yes. If that helps you in calming your mind, yes, definitely. All these things in which your brain is exercised are extremely important. That can help in maybe calming your mind. So spiritual.
And another thing you have said that we have to do new things, right? Learn new learning. According to Daniel Amen,
new learning is extremely important. And he says yes, that lifelong learning, two important things, lifelong learning and positive social connections are extremely important for a positive brain function. That is what Dr. Amen has been emphasizing.
Can this new learning be in your basic skills that you have?
If you advance your learning in that particular field, so be it. But it has to be a little bit new. It has to be a little bit challenging. So basically, whatever you know, it has to go a little bit beyond that. You have to go beyond that. Not just go on kind of revising or, you know, learning the same thing again and again.
All right. Thanks so much, Amrita. As always, very informative, very beautiful. Just a little pointer, if I could add, you know, Amrita, just a little concern that happens in our society, as you repeatedly keep saying, you know, older people feel they should not do this. Unfortunately, in our culture, especially since we have most of the women are on our family right now, you know, the limitation is, you know, and whether, you know, if you lost your husband, you're single, and also whichever male is around, you know, women demotivate the women. What will your children say? I would just like to say, yeah, just do what makes you happy, you know, that's important. We have to come out of these things.
Another thing, Shamim madam, is agar koi kuch kar raha hai to unko humko encourage karna chahiye.
Absolutely.
Ya fir appreciate karna chahiye. Hum log waisa karte hi nahi hai. Isko khicho, usko khicho.
Bilkul. So you all must not hesitate. Don't worry what is your status, whether you're saying. Don't worry about that. Do what makes you happy, you know, as long as your atma aapke saath hai, aapki ruh aapke saath hai, you know, just live, jilo zindagi, yehi hai, you know, don't worry, you know, especially when the children grow older, they feel, you know, what will the son say, what will the daughter-in-law say, samdhi kya bolenge, ye kya bolenge, wo kya bolenge, I mean, just do it, you know, I mean, and as I keep telling her, whatever practice, I try to tell you all that, you know, we have to come out of these norms. And that is a lesson for our children. The next generation will learn from our motivation. They will see us doing this. Okay, my mother, my grandmother does this. Yani hum kar sakte, achha kare. We are not harming anybody. We are growing. Personally, our mind is growing. We are getting more positive by nature. So yes, go ahead. And Amrita, thank you so much.
Very nice. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. It was very, very informative talk.
And very energetic. Yeah, very interesting.
Excellent. Very well explained. Very well explained and easy for us to follow.
Yeah. Follow, we will have this on our website, this entire recording will be on our website, yes.
Shamim, according to Vichardhara, only two lines, shall I explain? Shall I want only two lines?
Actually, we are past the time of Korean, and many people have other commitments after 6. Actually, we try to brush, but tomorrow you take it. As I always tell you, I will give you the chance tomorrow.
Okay. This is about jindagi.
अपनी जिंदगी तो रोज हम बात कर सकते हैं, जरूर कल हम आपको मौका देंगे कोरियन जी, हाँ रोज रोज बात करेंगे. ऑलराइट, टुमारो वी हैव बिंगो. इफ यू नॉट कलेक्टेड योर टिकट्स, डू कलेक्ट योर टिकट.